In this video, I will demonstrate a few properties for the image object. Image objects are used by programmers to give forms a nice appearance. For example, displaying logos. Users can also use an image object to load photos. This is the project that we started in Unit 6.1. We will continue with it in this tutorial. Our project already has panels, a button, a few bit buttons, labels, a few edits, a combo box and a spin edit on the form. After every video in this lesson, your user interface will evolve to look like this one. But in this tutorial, we will only put the image on to display a photo on our form. We will explore some of the properties for the image object. If the contact information project that you created in Unit 6.1 is not open, you must first open it in Delphi. Go to the folder that you created earlier and open contact information. Yeah, I already have it open. Now, before we do anything else, let's first make sure that we have a picture or a photo that we want to use for this application. I'm sure you must have a digital picture of yourself somewhere on your hard disk, or on your phone or your flash drive. If not, go and take a selfie and save it on the computer that you are working on. You must copy the picture into the same folder that you created for your application. Here's a picture of me in the Pictures folder. I right-click on the picture and I click Copy. I go to my desktop and I double-click on the Learn Delphi Intro folder to open it. Then I double-click the Contact Information folder to open that one. And here I right-click on the folder and click Paste. I have the picture in my application folder now. Now let's go back to Delphi. To display a picture on our form, we need an instance of the tImage class. The tImage class can be found in the Additional tab of the Tool Palette. Click tImage to select it. Click here in this panel to drop the image instance in the blank area. The default name of this image is Image1. We will change this name in another exercise. Image1 was placed inside Panel 2. So panel 2 is the container for this image object. Here we see that image 1 is listed as a child of panel 2. Select image 1. Go to the height property and change it to 110. Change the left property to 80. Scroll down and make the top 120. And also change the width property to 120. Now, let's load the picture we pasted in our application folder. Go to the picture property and select it. Click the browse button on the right-hand side of the picture property. A picture editor pops up. Click the load button. Now, browse to the picture you saved in the contact information folder. Select the picture and click the open button. The picture now displays in the picture editor. Click the OK button. The picture is now loaded in the image component, but sometimes the picture is too big or too small to fit into the image component. In this case, it is too big. To solve this problem, select the image, go to the stretch property and make it true. That looks much better, but it is still out of proportion. It makes me look a little fat. To fix that, go to the proportional property and change it to true. And that is how you go on a quick diet. Now, let's run the application and see what our users will see. Click the Run button or press F9 on your keyboard. Now that looks nice. Click the Close button. This is the end of the demonstration of the tImage class. We only loaded a specific picture that will be static on this form, but we can also allow the user to decide which picture he or she wants to load. To accomplish that, we need to write code, but more about that later. We will continue with this project in the next video, so click the Save All button. Now you must go and explore some of the properties of images in your own time before watching the next video. In the next video, we will explore checkboxes. I'll talk to you again in the next video.